Hello and welcome to another Magic Arena gameplay video. Today we're taking a look at another budget deck here on Channel Fireball, and make sure to check out the written article on the website as well. The link should be in the video description. And today's deck is Boros Cycling, a deck most people will already be familiar with. And in order to build the deck, if you start out with a brand new account, you'll need 26 common wildcards, 16 uncommons, and 5 rare wildcards. So the deck is pretty cheap to build in terms of rares and mythics required. And the good news is that currently Ikoria Premier Drafts are also available. So if you just need to pick up some of the commons and uncommons in the deck, it's a great time to do it. So let's dive right into it here. Boros Cycling, a deck that's going to spend most of its time cycling cards for 1 mana until it can fire off a giant Zenith Flare to kill the opponent on the spot. Zenith Flare dealing X damage to any target and gaining X life, where X is the number of cards with cycling in our graveyard. So that's going to be the big finisher in the deck. Then we've got a ton of cards with cycling, and some of the cards with cycling we actually want to cast, some of them we just want to cycle. And in the category of cards we actually want to cast, of course, we have Flourishing Fox, a 1 mana 1-1 that picks up a +1/+1 counter whenever we cycle another card, so that this can very quickly get out of hand. We also have a Valiant Rescuer, 2 mana 3-1, that makes a 1-1 token whenever we cycle our first card each turn. So we can cycle in our turn to make a token, and once again in the opponent's turn. So we essentially make 2 tokens in each turn cycle. And then Drenith Stinger deals 1 damage to each opponent whenever we cycle a card. So that complements our burn plan with Zenith Flare. And then Gopher Blood will occasionally cast if we have a large Flourishing Fox, so we can fight an opposing creature, so it can act as removal as well. And then Shredded Sails is just a well-positioned card in the metagame right now, as it can blow up one of those legendary artifacts out of the Gruul Adventure deck, and can still kill a Flying Rogue out of the Dimir deck. And then taking a look at the rest of the deck, most of the cards we're just going to cycle for 1 mana. That's why we have these off-color blue and black cards in the deck, since we can just cycle them for 1 mana to enable our various synergies. So Memory Leak, Frostfill Ambush, Startling Development, we're always going to cycle. Footfall Crater often going to be cycled as well. And then Drenith Healer, every now and then we might play as a creature if we just want to gain some life back, or if we need a 2 mana 2-2 in play. And then of course Zenith Flare, the big finisher for the deck. And then we also get to play with Lures of the Dream Den as our companion. That's going to be one of the rare wild cards. So this gives us access to all our cycling creatures again in the late game, which is great. And the 4 remaining rare wild cards are spent on Needle Verge Pathway, a nice dual land to make sure we can curve out smoothly. And then we have 6 basic mountains and 8 basic plains. Now I also want to remind you that this video is brought to you by Channel Fireball, in particular U-Box We Buy, the easiest way to sell your magic cards. Just throw them into a box, CFB does the sorting, the grading, and the pricing, and you get your cash fast and easy. So head on over to channelfireball.com/uboxwebuy or click the link in the description for more information, and be sure to use promo code LVD to let them know that I sent you. So that's our deck, now let's jump into some games and see how the deck does. Alright, we're on the play with a fine opening hand. We've got Rescuer and Stinger as cards we're happy to play out. And then a bunch of cyclers. Question is if I cycle something turn 1 or if I wait. I would like to hit my third land drop, so on turn 3 we can play a 2 drop and cycle. So I'm tempted to cycle here on turn 1. Ooh, Flourishing Fox, so change of plan. I think we'll play the Fox now. And then I'll probably just cycle now to play around the top decked 1 damage effect. Alright, so no third land just yet. Opponent on the red-green with a turn 2 Lotus Cobra. So if I cycle into a Go for Blood, I could maybe kill the Cobra. But chances of that happening are pretty low, so I think I would rather just develop my own board. Either with Rescuer or Stinger. I guess I'll go with the Rescuer for now. And then Fox can attack, and we'll cycle before damage. There's a Zenith Flare already. Probably don't want to use it to kill Cobra, typically want to save it to go face. So we've got double Stinger, which can also help us with burning out the opponents. Her opponent has 4 mana here, thanks to the Lotus Cobra. And it's going to be a Dryad, which lets him play one more land, so potentially have 3 mana. And it's even a Fabled Passage. So they still have 4 mana available, essentially. So yeah, that's a very scary start from the Gruul ramp deck. And a 2/4 blocker can also jump in front of my Rescuer now. And it's going to be a Florahedron, that one's okay. And our opponent passes. Alright, so I can play Stinger. And then attack with a Flourishing Fox. Opponent's about to take it, so we'll cycle once. And then I can cycle now to get one more damage in with a Fox, or I can wait to get one more token from the Rescuer. I don't think the tokens are going to matter all that much, so I think I'd rather get in one more damage. Sir points at 10, 5 cycling cards in graveyard for Zenith Flare. Next turn I can maybe put Lurrus in hand to eventually get back another Draenith Stinger. So I don't hate my position, but this is the turn where my opponent could do something pretty powerful with all the mana they have available. Shatterskull Smashing kills Stinger and Rescuer, but also puts 2 more cycling cards in my graveyard. So I only need to get 2 more points of damage in after we cycle Ambush. So if I were to attack with everyone, my opponent probably ends up chomping the Fox. So I could just attack with the Fox and then finish him off with a Zenith Flare. Yeah, I guess that's okay. And if they chomp, I'm also happy. And then we'll just put Lurrus in hands. And then I can still cycle twice end of turn. Don't expect my opponent to have a way of exiling my graveyard, which would be my primary concern. Ashaya, pretty strong with a Lotus Cobra too. All their creatures now enable landfall. So if I find one more cycling card, we can kill him with a Zenith Flare. And that should do it. Not gonna bother attacking here. And there we go. Early Flourishing Fox to get in some early damage. And then Stinger and Rescuer to kind of force my opponent to answer my board. And then a Zenith Flare to win the game. That's usually how it goes. On to the next one. Alright, we're on the play with a keepable hand. I'm missing red mana, but I've got a lot of cycling cards and then Rescuer as a fine 2-drop. Probably going to cycle Crater turn 1 here, or development, doesn't really matter. Just to hit my land drop. Could decide to wait on Rescuer until I can cycle and at least make a token, but I probably want to cycle Healer instead of playing it out, so this seems okay. Let's see what our opponent's up to. Gets a mountain. And the plains. And Rescuer gets exiled by a Spikefield Hazard, so we don't even get it back with Lurrus, and also doesn't count towards Zenith Flare. So yeah, that was unfortunate. I can just cycle three times here. Can put Lurus in hand, but it doesn't do much at the moment. So I guess we'll cycle once, see what we get. Alright, another Rescuers, not too bad. Opponent on Jeskai, so it could be a more controlling deck. Although there we see Hallowblade. So not sure what to make of this. Do I want to play Healer, or do we want to cycle it? Against Hallowblade, I mean, we can just make a bunch of Chum Blockers with a Rescuer. So, I think I'm fine just cycling. Shredded Sails I can maybe keep, in case they have Embercleave. And then... don't hate putting Lurus in hands, as opposed to just cycling again. And then no attack. Takedown kills Rescuer. I'll happily trade my token for a card in the opponent's hand, so I don't think my opponent's attacking here. So I could play Lurus, but I want to wait until we can get immediate value by getting back a key creature. So for now, we'll just cycle. Could play Healer first, but Healer doesn't do all that much here. And then we're just powering up our Zenith Flare. Do I play Healer now? Nah, I think I still wait. So let's cycle main phase in case we find a Flourishing Fox. And then we'll pass and can still decide to cycle Go for Blood, although I might want to wait so I can go Lurus, get back Rescuer and cycle to make a token. Pack Beast, I see, so this might be a Jeskai party deck. This is a warrior, this counts as all four creature types. So I could make the Lurus get back Rescuer play. Which sounds okay. Shredded Sails could have also destroyed the Pang Beast. We'll maybe do that next turn. Journey, gonna exile Lurus, presumably. That's fine. We're still pretty far from a lethal Zenith Flare, but Rescuer could start generating an army of tokens here to pressure the opponents. Second Rescuer. Do I want to play that one or cycle it? Might want to cycle that one, honestly. And then we'll destroy the Pack Beasts. And we can start getting in with our tokens. And then we can make two more tokens by cycling a Rescuer. And then we're pretty close to a lethal Zenith Flare. A robber plus another pack beast, so they're close to a full party. They've got warrior, rogue, and then this is the third type. At this point, I probably cycle the fox, so can play stinger, cycle fox. See what we get. And if I attack with everyone, we should have lethal here. I was about to say my opponent could have the party spell pierce here, and yeah, there it is, concerted defense. I think this is the first time I've seen this cast in any format. So yeah, maybe could have played around it by waiting until my turn to cast Zenith Flare, but wasn't really expecting this. Although my draws are not great. So now if I attack with everyone, what happens? They've got 7 blockers. I guess I just get in with tokens. Opponent doesn't have a full party yet for squad commander, and this time we should be able to play around concerted defense. GG's. Alright, on to the next one. Alright, we're on the play with not such an amazing hand, no white mana and no real cycling payoffs here, so we're just going to be doing nothing for the first couple turns. I think this is a mulligan. Alright, this is much better. So turn 1 fox, turn 2 I might play Rescuer first. Is this a hand where I bottom the Zenith Flare? Nah, probably not. Maybe I just bottom the Rescuer and then hope that the fox gets there, but if they answer the fox, I want to have another payoff card. So I guess we'll just bottom the crater then. And then I'm hoping to find more cycling cards as opposed to lands. At least in the early turns. Alright, they did have a 1 mana answer for fox, so glad I kept the Rescuer. Experts, kind of annoying, probably gets to take my land. Stinger I also kind of want to play instead of cycle. Scavengers, your opponent appears to be on mono black. And yeah, the lifelink on Scavenger means it's pretty difficult to race. So I might have to use Zenith Flare to just take it out eventually. Found a land. Yeah, I think I'm cycling the Stinger instead of playing it out here. Just need to hit my land drops for Zenith Flare. Demonic Embrace. I think I got a cycle now, because if I find a land I can Zenith Flare right away. Alright, so we get to take out Scavenger before it does more damage. Stinger gets to hit for two. And now we can try and take over the late game with Lurrus. Surprised they didn't adventure the Murderous Rider first. Another Rescuer. I guess I'm into just playing it here. So their plan might be to put the Demonic Embrace on Murderous Rider next turn. So I wouldn't mind finding another Zenith Flare. Alright, so we don't have much going on here. Can attack and then put Lurrus in hand. Rankle. It's just a 3-power flyer here, so that's going to threaten lethal for next turn. The sacrifice ability not super relevant, at least. And I guess we'll cycle. So I need Zenith Flare, so I might as well cycle now to improve my chances of finding it. Cycle main phase. I don't think Lurrus does anything relevant. If I get back Healer, I don't have the mana to cycle afterwards. Shredded Sails, wow, that actually does it too. Although, I guess they have two flying creatures here. So it doesn't actually keep me alive. Man, so close. So what are my options now? I think I'm out of options. Can attack, but don't have 19 damage lined up. Yeah, if we had a Zenith Flare, we would have had lethal, I think. Let's see, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Would have been exaxes. Can't really think of much that saves me, unless they don't attack with Rankle for some reason. Expert happens. Wow, my opponent only attacked with Murderous Rider, so we actually get to live. That's incredible. I bet they weren't expecting a shred sales. Cycle ambush. And yeah, I think that might just be game over if we attack with everyone here. And my opponent concedes. So yeah, this is a great illustration of why you should always play it out instead of conceding before the game is actually over. So not sure what compelled my opponent to stay back with Rankle, but it's definitely played in our favor. Alright, we're on the play with a nice opening hand with a turn 1 Fox. No red mana just yet, but with all these cycling cards we'll find it eventually. And then of course always nice to have a Zenith Flare to count on to close out the game. Let's see what our opponent is up to. Turn 1 Plains, and an Alsade of a Life's Bounty. There's my red mana. And I'm just gonna cycle now. Next turn we can play a Stinger and cycle again. Is this maybe a Glass Casket to answer the Fox? I hope not. Nope, opponent passes. So yeah, we'll play Stinger. And an Angelic Ascension to exile the Fox, turn it into a 4-4. Alright, fair enough. So we can't even get it back with Lures here. But we do have a 4-4 flyer. Although now Glass Casket is gonna exile it, so Shredded Sails to blow up Casket is no longer that appealing. And a Sentinel's Eyes on the Alsade. And do I want to trade? It's not a bad trade. Yeah, I guess so. And then now it's time for Rescuer. Cycle once in my turn. Probably hang on to Shredded Sails. My opponent could be playing with like Legion Angel. And then it's nice to have a removal spell. Also, next turn I'm probably playing the second Rescuer and cycling the Sails. A Luminarch Aspirant, sure. And our opponent's deciding whether they want to escape Sentinel's Eyes. Can still attack into it with a Rescuer for one turn. So we'll play a Rescuer. And do I want to cycle Sails or Healer? We'll cycle the Sails. And hit for 3. And then next turn I can maybe cycle and then put Lures in hands. Not too far from a lethal Zenith Flare. Hallow Blades doesn't line up all that well against all my 1-1 tokens. Suppose they could put counters on it with the aspirants, but opponents empty-handed, so they can make Hellblade indestructible at the moment. So, what's next? Cycle developments. And then I could attack with both Rescuers. They probably trade one for the Hallowblade. Flourishing Fox is interesting. At this point I probably just cycle the Fox instead of playing it out. So do I want to trade risk here for Hellblade? I don't think so. We'll just keep making tokens. Another Hellblade. Alright, so I can go Lurus, get back Stinger, and that's my turn. Or I can cycle a bunch. I would like to keep making more tokens, so maybe I go Lurus, get back Flourishing Fox, and I can still cycle, maybe hit my land drop. And then if we hit our land drop, we can cycle again in the opponent's turn with the Rescuers. Not quite at the point where I wanted to attack with everyone here. But maybe next turn. Well, that should seal the deal. They don't have any good attacks. And yeah, my opponent just concedes. Even without Zenith Flares, they're just gonna lose to Lurus, eventually getting back Stingers. So yeah, managed to beat the Mono White Life Gain deck, which is definitely a popular best of one deck with a pretty high win rate. Alright, we're on the play. Missing white mana. Double Zenith Flare, I mean, it's a great card, but it's not really one we necessarily want in our opening hand. So this one is a bit of a gamble. If we don't find white mana right away, we're in trouble. But I do get to cycle two 1-mana cyclers to find lands. So I'll try it. Turn one Apprentice, gonna mill me. It's actually good. If we're playing against a mill deck, already having two copies of Zenith Flare in hand is great, since those can just win a game by themselves, as long as they don't get countered. So just gotta hit our land drops. And that's perfect. Ventress Gargoyle. Alright, that one can definitely kill me by just attacking four times, so... Probably gonna cycle before playing another Rescuer just to hit my land drop. I did not find a land, sadly. And this can currently block, so can't attack. By cycling, we do speed up the rate at which Gargoyle can potentially attack. Alright, I'll play a Fox. Gets countered, sure. If we can get those counter spells out of their hands, that would be great. And now I have to decide if I want to play another Rescuer. Yeah, I guess I do. So we're one land away from Zenith Flare, which already deals 8 damage. and a Merfolk Windrobber. Okay. And Secret Keeper mills for 4. So my opponent is tapped out. Sadly, no lands to let us cast Flare, but that's okay. So do I want to play another Rescuer? I think I'm just gonna try and find lands, so I might end up cycling the Rescuer as well. There's a land. So now do I Rescuer? Yeah, it's probably fine. And then I just need one of these Zenith Flares to resolve realistically to gain life necessary to survive the Gargoyle attacks. So if their last card's a counterspell, that could be an issue. So, probably time to attack with everyone. If they have a counterspell, I lose anyway. To the Gargoyle and Windrobber attacking me. And that was Zenith Flare's lethal. Best timing is probably in the opponent's upkeep in case they cast an end of turn draw spell. And hope this resolves. Windrobber can draw a card. Alright, so they don't have a counterspell in hand, they're digging for one, but Gargoyle by itself is not lethal anymore. So I think we're very likely to win now that we'll get to untap and cast our second Zenith Flare even if they counter the first one. And yeah, 15 to the face. So, against any sort of mill deck, Zenith Flare can be quite punishing as well. So we got to see a nice variety of matchups here with our Boros Cycling deck. Definitely one of the more competitive budget decks you can build on Arena right at this time. So definitely recommend it if you're looking for a deck to quickly get your daily wins and complete your quests, although I guess you're not actually casting all that many spells since you're spending most of your time cycling, so completing your color quests might be a little bit more difficult. But yeah, that's gonna do it for today's gameplay. Wanna thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed, and as always, have a nice day.